I feel like it's supposed to go from under. We'll see what happens. Okay, and then so you slide your thread on there. And then you pick out your matching size thingy because they come with different size thingies. So you pick out the thingy that it matches the size to. If you pick one that's the wrong size, it can get caught on it. And then, so this might be a little bit different for different machines, but the sewing machines normally have like little directions that show you where it needs to go. But for mine, there's this little thingy right here. So I gotta put it in there. And then it goes around this way. And then it goes down this thing. And then it goes under and back up again. And then there's a little metal piece inside of there. And you do want, you have to make sure that it's like up all the way. It's connected to the needle. So as the needle goes up and down, this little metal piece goes up and down. So you want to make sure the needle is in the up position, and then this will be up. And thread catches on that when you loop it around. And then the last part is hooking it like, well, it's not the last part. There's like a little thingy above the needle that it hooks onto, and that keeps it from getting caught on this screw that's holding in the needle, which I've done before, and I broke the needle that way because I forgot to thread this part, and the thread ended up flying over this way, and when the needle went back down, it pulled the thread, and it just went, and the needle went like in the machine, and then I had to like dig it out, and I was like, oh god, I broke my sewing machine. But then it was okay. So the last part is actually threading the needle. And my machine has a needle threader built into it, but I didn't try to figure out how it works yet. Because I don't know why. I just didn't. It should catch the bobbin thread. There it is. So I'm pulling on this one right now, and it's pulling up my bobbin thread from underneath. Because then you have to pull them both out. So now you have both strings pulled out. So for other machines, if you're going to change your stitch length and stuff, if it's not computerized, it'll have more dials like this one across here, and then you'll change it manually. That's the other fun thing about having, oh, when you thought I broke my sewing machine. Yeah, I got really scared, but I ended up fixing it. So anyway, so the other fun thing about having the computerized machine is it will automatically choose a stitch length and width that is commonly used for that type of stitch. So if you're not exactly sure what might be normal, you can just kind of go with the default, whatever it goes to, and then change it from there. So that's nice. And so in this case, this is my stitch length, this is the stitch width. And I have different options for my straight stitch. I can set it so that the needle is all the way to the left, which is what it's at right now. If I move it over to number one, it puts the needle in the center. So sometimes it's easier to like measure out the distance when it's in the center or when it's off to the left, or depending on how much seam allowance you have, sometimes you have to like move your fabric over farther, and instead of having to go like off the edge of your foot, it helps to be able to adjust where the needle is starting from. I don't know if that makes any sense explaining it like that. But yeah, and then for now, I'm going to use a straight stitch because I'm just going to do a basting stitch. That's the temporary stitch, so I'm going to do this number three. It's like a zigzaggy stitch. There it goes. The number three, this is a stretch stitch. So when I do the final one, that's what I'm going to use. It makes it so that it stretches with the fabric and the seams won't pop. Whereas this one, if you really stretch it, it's just going to rip the stitches right out. But stretch stitches are really hard to rip out when you need to rip them out. So in this case, like I said, I'm going to do it temporary with the intention of having to take the seams back out later on because I need to make sure that it fits me well. So I'm going to do a straight stitch and I'm going to set this right now, it's at 2.5. So I'm going to bump it up and put it at 5.0. And that's the longest stitch that my machine will do. And so this will be called a basting stitch. Hi, Amy!
Another pin stabbing me.
Okay, so the other thing that I need to do now is I need a ruler again. What even is this? I don't even know what this is. This looks like it would be a ruler, but it doesn't even have any measurement things on it. What is this? What is this? Is this like a bookmark? What is this? I don't know. Why do I have this? Away. It's the handy dandy Batman here. So there's different markings on my actual machine that can help me decide the length, because you're measuring the length like from the needle so that you know. So when I marked earlier, when I had my pattern like this, how there's two lines. Well, now there's not two lines because I cut out the outside line. But there's a line on the inside that goes around the whole thing. That's where the actual stitches should go. And then the outside of that is like the extra. So you need to measure like from the edge of your fabric to where the needle should be. So that's what these are here to help with. So you'll line up the edge of the fabric with one of these lines, and then that gives you something to follow as you go so that you stay in line with where you're sewing and don't like go like So I need to figure out which one of these lines I'm going to, because I used a half inch to do my seam allowance, so I need to measure a half an inch from the edge of my fabric now. Okay, good night, Lake Wolf, I say as I yawn too. Oh, now it's 1:30. Wasn't it like 12:30 the last time I looked?
Dang.
But thanks for hanging out again, Link. It's good to see you again. You should go to town and save the Princess Zelda. Okay. Well, I'm not gonna sew the top of this yet, because I need to get into it. The plan is to cut into the back to add a zipper later on. So for now, I'm not really gonna have a way to get back into it if I sew it all the way around, so I'm gonna leave the top part open. Okay, so if I've got the needle set to the center position, it's about where this line is right here. So I'm gonna follow that to get my half inch measurement all the way around. Hopefully everything works. Pressing the pedal for the first time in months is kind of scary.
Get my chair in here.
I think it's helping. I mean, I hopefully it's helping because it's an expensive chair.
Yeah.
Okay. And again, for anybody who came in after I said it, I'm doing a temporary stitch for now until I get it fitted correctly, because I'll probably need to tweak it once I put it on. So for right now, I'm using black thread because I couldn't find my red thread that I've used before. Because I use basically the same kind of red for my Jareth cosplay, so I was going to use that leftover thread, but I don't know where it is. So for right now, we're using black because it's going to come out anyway. Doesn't matter. So, okay. Hopefully this goes okay. Yeah. I'm nervous because I feel like something's gonna explode and like I forgot something. But I think I did everything.
It looks better. Well, Ori got me this for my birthday. So yeah. The old one's over there on the floor. So, yeah, it's probably that.
And he also got me a chair. I don't know where that's a good angle. I guess that works. And the audio, I guess, is better for you guys now too, because this mic is deciding to cancel out the noise of the music, so I can't just play it externally like I normally do, so it's playing through the desktop right now. The downside is that I'm pretty sure if I try to like sing along or if I start humming or something, it's going to be off from the music, so that might be annoying. But at least I don't have to use headphones, because that was the other thing I was afraid of, is that I'd need to use headphones and they get in my way. But I was told by the people earlier that it's not picking up the audio that I hear, except for a little bit when I talk, maybe. Maybe it'll cancel out the noise of this ka-chunk, ka-chunk, ka-chunk of the sewing machine. That would probably be good. I guess let's find out. I guess I need to, like, press this pedal and see what happens. Let me set my speed slow so I can get back into this. Oh, look at that. It's alive. Okay. Cheeky little GameCube. That one's Ori's GameCube too. Mine is still in New Jersey. I had like the right colored GameCube because my GameCube was the purple GameCube, and the purple GameCube is the best GameCube. But anyway, I really like GameCube. GameCube was like one of the, like, I always thought it was like a really cute console. And I remember when I still had like Nintendo Power magazine back in the day, and they showed like the first, like, here we go. They showed like the first screenshots. Let's see. I was trying to look up to see if my mic is catching this or not. But I also need to look at what I'm doing. It looks like it's not, so that's good. Anyway, I remember when the first screenshots came out for the GameCube, how it was gonna look. The graphics, I guess, is the word I want. And I remember being like blown away because it was like from Nintendo 64 to GameCube, and I was like, oh my god! How is that even possible that video games are gonna look so great and so amazingly detailed in 3D? Link's nose isn't a triangle anymore. Oh my god. Oh god. And now it's like you look back at the GameCube and realize how much farther we've come since then. Like, oh my god. Damn, stab myself with a pin. Damn, stab myself with a pin over here. What the heck? I don't know if this will just get in my way. My hand might also just be in the way too. But maybe not. Maybe this works. You can get a better idea of what I'm doing. And you can see my nasty thumb that I pick out all the time. I pick out both of them, really. So on the one hand, it's easier to have the pins facing that way, so like the point is on this end, and then the blunt end is on this end, so it's easier for me to pull it out as I go if I need to. In this case, I pinned it real close to the edge, and it's, so far they've all been going like on the other side of the needle, so I haven't needed to. But if they're ever in the way, I need to pull them out, it's easier this way. But now the problem is, if I get my fingers in front of it as the fabric is going this way, I keep like dabbing myself. But you're not supposed to sew over pins. At least as far as I've seen, it seems like there's like some machines are fine sewing over pins and some aren't, I guess. I don't know if it's like the difference between a home machine and like an industrial machine or something, but I always see like warnings against not sewing over pins because you can break the needle that way. So I'm just like, I'll go with not sewing over them just in case. Okay, I'm not gonna bother going all the way to the bottom of this because this is the part that's gonna be covering up the shoe. I'm not exactly sure where my leg is actually going to end, but that's not super important for now because I can't finish that until I have a shoe to put in it anyway. So, and normally if this wasn't a temporary stitch at this point, wah, rip stream again! What the heck? We're back. Hello. I guess I can look myself. Looks like we're still ripped. No, 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 no. I was playing an advertisement. Just show me my stream so I can see if I'm alive. Our internet likes to be crappy. Okay, now I see myself. So, I would say it's pretty likely that that's what it is. Anywho, so this part is actually eventually going to be covering my shoe, because her shoes are kind of built into the bodysuit. So I'm leaving that open for now. I don't know exactly where my legs are gonna end, but it doesn't really matter at this point, because I'll be adjusting that once there's a shoe. So anyways, so if this was not a temporary stitch and it was going to be permanent, at this point you would press this little button and that will make the fabric go backwards. And so you can go back and forth by doing that, and then the stitches will all go over top of each other, and it locks them all in place, and it makes them really difficult to take back out. Excuse me. So I am not going to do that right now because it's temporary, because I want to be able to have the option to take it back out. So, well, first I gotta, that's the other handy dandy thing that I got with this sewing machine is I can press the button and it'll either raise or lower the needle. So that once I stop, because this is set to stop with the needle in the fabric. And that makes it easier for if you need to go around a corner. So like if I go boop and put it in there, if I needed to go around a corner right now, you can lift up the foot and then pivot this. And then the needle won't ever come out of the fabric. And so it makes it easier. That's the other good thing about a computerized machine, even though Linkwolf isn't here anymore. Is that you can do things like that where it's set to automatically stay in the fabric. So it's just something small that takes out something that could cause you to make a mistake, and it also takes out extra time for you having to pay attention to it and actually like crank the wheel over here. On a motorized machine, you'd have to actually like turn that by hand to raise and lower the needle. But in this case, I don't need to do that. I can just press the button. And then I've got a little fabric cutter, or not fabric cutter, thread cutter back here. To chop off the thread. And so that's one side. I guess I'll go down the other side, and then I'll go up the inside of the leg, I guess. Let's see. I guess I want to start from the leg opening this time because I want my fabric to go this way still, because my pins are on this side. If I start at the other end, then I either need to sew this way, and now I won't be able to line it up with the lines anymore, or I need to put it upside down, and now the pins are on the underside and I can't see where they are. So I need to start at the leg opening for this one. Let's see about where I stopped on this one. Okay. so I'm picking that same line that I used before. There we go. That's what I wanted. Okay. But like this pin is kind of going awkwardly, like, so I'm gonna move this one out of the way so I don't sew over it. Oh yeah. Well, here's the Sewing 101 class. There's a lot of sewing tutorials on YouTube, so it hasn't been too hard for me to get into sewing so far. So hopefully it won't be too bad for you either. The main thing for me that's scary is making the pattern for something to fit right. And then I think the only things that was the only things that really were like hard for me to sew so far were the glove rolls for Sailor Pluto. I was looking around because I was gonna say if they were near me I would grab them, but they're not near me, they're in my room. Since there's like stuffing in them, it was hard for me to like so like I am right now, because it was like this part had stuffing in it, so it was like it didn't really lay flat and it made it like I had to sew really close to the edge and it was a pain in the butt. So that was kind of hard. And then when I sewed the satin together for the bows, I did a collar on stream. I think you were here that night too, where I used like a million pins so that the two layers wouldn't like slide around when they were going. So that was kind of difficult, I guess, but it turned out okay in the long run, so it was fine. So yeah, those were like the main things, I think. Oh, and sewing the skirt to the hip roll for Sailor Pluto, because it was two different fabric types, and sewing those two together, since I had to make it come to a really nice point in like a V shape, that was really difficult because the fabric kept trying to stretch weird, and it was like no matter what I wanted to do, it just wanted to be funky. And it kind of worked out the same way for the top edge of the boot covers, where it has the white strip on the top. It was kind of the same deal with that too. So it's like sewing weird things can be kind of hard, but sewing just basic things where it's like two of the same flat fabric together, like this is right now, is not too bad. So far. I guess I haven't done complicated things yet. Oh, well. Fear Venom, thanks for following, except that you're banned. I forgot what I was gonna say. Oh, I was gonna say, I'm planning on putting a zipper in the back of this because it's gonna be a turtleneck, so I probably will not be able to squeeze my whole body into this through the turtleneck opening. So I'm gonna have to install a zipper in the back, which I have not done yet, so this will be my first time learning how to do that. But hopefully that doesn't turn out to be more terrible than it looks like it would be. Gluing involved? I don't even remember anymore. I ended up gluing some of my the top piece, the hem for it, because I didn't want to have like a visible seam or like visible stitching. So I ended up just folding it under and gluing it in place so that there wouldn't be stitches. And also because I was running out of time. Oh god, a little too pedal heavy there. Alright, there we go. Yeah. Okay.
Weird.
So this is a time where it's good to leave the needle in the fabric and then lift the foot up, so then it lets me move the fabric around so it doesn't get all bunched up under here. But it's also going to keep my stitching in line with where I was already stitching. But, goody. Turned a little farther than where I want to be. Looks like that made a good curve.
Okay.
That's a pitiless light in a way. Back with breakfast. Okay. Well, we should kind of have some kind of bodysuit going on here. I guess I will try this on, see what we get, see how much we're gonna need to do to fix it. And then, like, 212, so that'll probably be it for the night. I'm not gonna actually try and adjust it tonight, but I wanna at least see where we're at. But tomorrow we're supposed to go see family for Mother's Day. So if I get started with doing any more than what I'm already doing, it's gonna get real late. Okay. I think that's all the pins. Well, it actually might not be that much of a challenge to get it to fit. My Sailor Pluto leotard was kind of a pain though. The first time it was a pain because the pattern that I used had too short of a torso. So it wasn't long enough. So the way it was stretched out when I wore it made it so that it didn't lay flat against my back, and it kind of like bubbled out from my back, like it didn't follow the curve of my back. And it was like too tight, so it wasn't comfortable either. So I had to completely remake that one. And then it was kind of like the shape of the pattern itself that made it a pain. Like I had to do a lot of pinning and try it and on again, and then repinning and trying it on again to make it fit right. So this one, I started off with my actual finished Sailor Pluto leotard, and I traced that instead of the original pattern. So hopefully this will be closer to fitting me right than the last time. And for the legs, I used a pair of leggings that I wear for my Jareth cosplay. So hopefully this will be closer to fitting me to begin with, but I don't know. And I erred on the side of it being longer in the torso, because if it is too long, if like the crotch is really low, I can always like here. So like there's the crotch. If this is too low, I can always like sew it higher if I need to. If it needed to be lower, that would be a problem. But if I need it higher and this is too low, I can just sew it higher and then cut out the extra in the middle. So making it too big is better than making it too small. So I don't know what this is gonna look like right now, but I'm gonna find out and I'll come back. Okay, that took a really long time.
Am I offline? Because my thing says I'm offline.
Also, I have clothes on under this, so nobody be alarmed. I've been wearing a tank top and leggings under everything I've been wearing all day so that I could try this on and not be naked underneath. Which is part of the reason why it took a long time to put it on, because it was sticking to my clothes. But I don't know if I'm there. Am I there? You guys see me? On my phone it says I was offline. Okay, good, I'm here. Okay, so let me see if I can. Oh, you're far away. Okay. So here's what we got going on. So I do need to bring the crash up higher because I have this extra. So if I make this stretch down to where it needs to be, then the crotch is going to be down here. So I'm going to need to bring that up higher, but otherwise that looks like the main thing that will fix the rest. And since it's temporary stitches, they're already like popping when from me trying to pull it on. So it looks all like bunched up at the seams because the seams are temporary. Oh, is it the hole? Yeah, it popped already when I tried putting it on. This is why you have to use a stretch stitch on your final stitch, or it'll just come right off. Because if you pull on a straight stitch, it just goes dink, and it'll break. So that's what happened when I tried pulling it on, and I have my leggings on underneath, and that is why I wanted to be clothed underneath. But it also made it harder to pull them up because they're sticking to my leggings underneath. But yeah, so right now it looks kind of bunchy because there's extra fabric, but I'm just gonna have to pull this up higher, like stretch it down and see how low the crotch is, and then kind of measure how many inches I need to bring it up. And then this part I didn't sew together yet so that I could get into it, but it's the top half. So we're gonna have to make a turtleneck onto this part, and then I also need to make the sleeves, obviously. But oh god, I'm ripping my crotch seams. Oh, but legs. Okay, so I guess that mostly worked out. Yeah, I was expecting more of a sloppy onesie kind of thing too, but it's actually fitting pretty tight already. It's just too long in the torso now, but that is easier to fix than it being too short. So, I'm like holding this on even though I'm not naked, but it would be weird if I like... I look beautiful right now. Nobody report me, I'm not naked, I promise. I have a tank top on, it's like normal clothes, but it feels weird. There, now it's more of the illusion of me not being naked. Okay. This is not the most flattering angle for me. I'll just put this. Okay, so I guess that's all for tonight. Well, yeah, it's supposed to be tight though, but it's extra tight being worn over another pair of leggings. Okay, so I guess that's it for tonight. Because I need to try to wake up to do family things tomorrow. So, I guess there's a possibility of me streaming during the week. I know that I always say that and I never end up doing it though, so I don't know how likely it is. But I might. If not, then I should be back this weekend working on it more. Yeah. I might work on it a little bit off stream this week if I'm like super tired and I don't feel like streaming. Or maybe another 2 months. I'm really sorry in advance if that happens, but I want to try to do as much of this on stream as possible. So, since I'm in the middle of actually working on it now, I should be back more. So, yeah, I'm gonna not. Yeah. So I'm gonna try to come back sooner rather than later. I can't make any promises, but it's close to a promise. I just realized that I threw some of my extra fabric in my cat's food bowl. That's nice. Okay, so thanks everybody for hanging out. I'm excited about this costume so far. It feels like things are going in the right direction for this to be working out. I'm nervous about making the vest and the like gold parts because they need to be like stuffed and they need to like wrap around my body. So I don't know how that's going to turn out. But so far, so good, I think. So thank you everybody for hanging out. Hopefully things were like smoother today now that I have the new laptop and things aren't as terrible as they were before. And hopefully I'll see you guys soon. Have good Mother's Days and stuff. I'll wait till the end of the song. Kashana's in the house, y'all. Okay.
Okay, bye.